You're still out here doing these songs, you know, you're still on tour.
I do, but I don't take it for granted.
Why do you still do it? Why are you still out here?
Well, it goes back to the destiny thing. I mean, I made a bargain with it, you know, a long time ago, and I'm holding up my end.
What was your bargain?
To get where I am now.
Should I ask who you made the bargain with?
with the chief commander
on this earth
and in this earth and then in the world we can't see.
Bob Dylan has been nominated.
Like, now I have to do something pretty ridiculous and insane with my life. So why not sell my soul and go on Jersey Shore? That's what I did. And you know what? It's been awesome.
So you're always being watched. Now, yeah. You sign up for that in the contract. You know that's going to happen.
Yeah, we sell our soul.
Well, that's an awful way to live. That really would steal someone's soul.
I think you are an amazing singer. I just want to know, what sort of advice would you give an aspiring singer or actress? You know, Hollywood can be a really hard town to try to break into. And what kind of advice would you give someone before they embark on this incredible journey? Thank you, and I hope you answer my question.
When I was 15, because I grew up in a household where all I ever did was listen to gospel music, and my parents are both traveling ministers, and so I kind of sang about, you know, what was going on in my life at 15, and that's how I got introduced to the music industry. I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
The boy in the bubble who never could adapt. I'm trapped. If I could go back, I never would have rapped. I sold my soul to the devil, I'll never get it back. I'm the boy in the bubble who never could adapt. I'm trapped, if I could go back, I never would've rapped. I sold my soul to the devil, I'll never get it back. I just wanna leave this game with level headed. The boy in the bubble who never could adapt. I'm trapped, if I could go back, I never would've rapped. I sold my soul to the devil, I'll never get it back.
Lucifer, yeah. Done of the morning, I'm gonna chase you out of earth. Lucifer, Lucifer, done of the morning.
I'm from the murder capital, where we murder for capital.
Lucifer, done of the morning, I'm gonna chase you out of earth.
You did it again, you're a genius.
Lucifer, Lucifer, done of the morning.
So you niggas changed your attitude for the asking what happened.
Singer?
Yeah, and it like really upset me, so I like summon Satan and I write about how I'm it's in the chapter called Eat, Pray, Love, Conjure Satan. It's in there. 12 years old, I signed a deal with Satan in my room, and I was... Because I wanted to get famous no matter what, and, you know, then I forgot that I had this deal with Satan and everything, and then I got really famous. I realized then that Satan was coming for my soul, so,
no.
Yeah, he wanted me to pay up, so... And how at the end I invite Satan to dinner at Spago. And ask him to, you know, give me a refinance on my soul thing. And so that works out. It has a happy ending.
Oh, that's... So you and Satan are good then?
Yeah, Satan, I have to say it's really cool because I totally...
Satan is not true! You can't say that!
I said I kind of, I lure him in, see?
Oh, and then you have a fiddle competition. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's the way to do it, yeah. Do you play the fiddle?
No.
Any musical instrument?
Well, I have taken musical lessons in my life, but I don't really play, I forgot it, I don't know. I took the piano for a while.
Right.
What a weird question.
Arrived live on the scene of a murder that happened late last night, and although details are very sketchy, we do know that one of the shooting victims is rapper Snoop Doggy Dogg. There was apparently a lot of gunfire here.
Aquí abrazaron el Snoop Doggy Dogg. No sabemos por qué es motivo, pero.
My mind starts tripping, a tear drops my eye. My body temperature falls. I'm shaking, and they breaking, trying to save the dough. Pumping on my chest and I'm screaming. I stop breathing, damn, I see demons. Dear God, I wonder can you save me? I can't die, my boo-boo's about to have my baby. I think it's too late for praying. Hold up, her voice spoke to me and it slowly started saying,
bring your life down to me, I'll make it better.
And how long will I live?
Eternal life then forever.
Oh, will I be the G that I was?
I'll make your life better than you can imagine or even dreamed of. So relax yourself, let me take control. Close your eyes, my soul.
My eyes are closed. My coma. I got my mama and my daddy and my homies in my corner. It's gonna take a miracle, like safe for me to walk again and talk again. But anyway, I get funny, some keys to get back on my feet. And everything that nigga said came to reality. Living like a baller low, I'm having money and blowing hella chronic smoke. I bought my mama a Benz, my boo-boo a Jag, and now I'm rolling in the nitrous AL though, right?
Just remember who changed your mind, cause when the store said tripping, that ass is mine.
And then, a great proceed to smoke weed. Never have a want, never have a need. They say I'm greedy, but I still want more, cause my eyes wanna journey some more. Fill it up,
check it out.
If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my murder was the case that they gave me.
Way to Chino, rolling on the Grey Goose, shackled from head to toe. 25 with the SL, with nowhere to get, so I know them niggas from the other side recognize my face, cause it's the OG, D-O-double-G-L-B-C. Man, dogging niggas, cause I don't care. Red jumpsuit with two braids in my hair. Niggas stare as I enter the center. They send me to a level 3 yard, that's where I stay. Late night, I hear two brushes scraping on the floor. Niggas getting they shanks, just in case the war pops off. Cause you can't tell what's next. My little homie, baby booty, took a pencil in his neck. And he probably won't make it to C-22. I'll put that on my mama, I'ma ride for you, baby boo.
I keep on dancing with the devil. Ah, I keep on dancing with the devil. My soul, there ain't no turning back. I keep on dancing with the devil.
Hello. My name is Montague William III. And what I will tell you may well sound absurd, but the less who believe it, the better for me. For you see, I'm in banking and a big industry. For many a year, we have controlled your lives, while you all just struggle and suffer in strife. We created the things that you don't really need, your sports cars and fashions and plasma TVs. I remember it clearly how all this began. Family secrets from father to son. Inherited knowledge that gives me the edge, while you peasant people lie sleeping at night in your beds. We control the money that controls your lives. Whilst you worship false idols and wouldn't think twice about selling your souls for a place in the sun, these things that won't matter when your time is done. But as long as they're there to control the masses, I just sit back and consider my assets, safe in the knowledge that I have it all, while you common people are losing your jobs. You see, I just hold you in utter contempt. But the smile on my face, well, it makes me exempt. For I have the weapon of global TV, which gives us connection and invites empathy. You would really believe that we look out for you, while we bankers and brokers are only a few. But if you saw that, you'd take back the power. Hence, daily terrors to make you all cower. The panics, the crashes, the wars, and the illness that keep you from finding your spiritual wholeness. We rig the game, and we buy out both sides to keep you enslaved in your pitiful lives. So, go out and work as your body clock fades. And when it's all over, a few years from the grave, you'll look back on all this, and just then, you'll see that your life was nothing, a mere fantasy. There are very few things that we don't now control. To have lawyers and police force was always a goal, doing our bidding while you march on the street. But they never realize that they're only just sheep. For real power resides in the hands of a few. You voted for parties. What more could you do? But what you don't know is they're one and the same. Old Gordon has passed good old David the reins, and you'll follow the leader who was put there by you. But your blood, it runs red, while our blood runs blue. But you simply don't see it's all part of the game. Another distraction, like money and fame. Get ready for wars in the name of the free, vaccinations for illness that will never be, the assault on your children's impressionable minds, and a microchipped world. You'll put up no fight. Information suppression will keep you in tone. Depopulation of peasants was always our goal. But eugenics was not what we hoped it would be. Oh, yes. It was us that funded Nazis. But as long as we own all the media, too, what's really happening does not concern you. So just go on watching your plasma TV, and the world will be run by the ones you can't see.